As a game developer, text is one of your most important tools for conveying information to the player, which is why it is incredibly important that the text in your game actually looks good. And I know that you probably don't want to spend hours doing so, which is why in this video I'll explain how to use 5 of the most useful text mesh pro-rich text tags to make your text look good with very little effort. But make sure you stick around to the end because I have made sure that these tags get progressively more useful as we go. So let's start off with the 4 simplest but most important tags that you'll use. The bold, italics, underline, and strike through tags. They can be used to easily emphasize individual words. All you need to do is type a letter in angle brackets at the start of the text you want to emphasize, and then a forward slash and then the same letter also in angle brackets. Using a B will make it bold, an I will put it in italics, an S we'll put it in strike through, and then you will underline it. Next is the align tag. Have you ever wanted to make a heading in the middle of a block of text? If you haven't, that's fine, but sometimes it's just a lot more convenient to put it in the middle of a box of text as opposed to making several boxes of text for different headings. With the align tag, you can place a header right in the middle of the box of text centered, and all you have to do is in your angled brackets type align equals and then however you want to align your text. For example, with a header, you could do align equals center. Another very useful tag is the size tag. You can use this one to change the size of a few words of text very easily. Probably the best example of how to use this one would be to make your header a larger font size than the rest of your text. All you would need to do for this one is type size equals and the font size in your angled brackets. The color tag is probably the best tag you can use to provide emphasis on certain words and works especially well with other tags such as the bold tag. An example of where the color tag could come in useful is if you want to associate one word or like a name of a character or something with something bad. Maybe if you wanted that, you could just color the name red, and then when the player sees that, they'll be like, oh, this character is bad. There are many possible ways to use this tag, which is why it's one of my favorites. All you need to do to use it is just color equals and then a hex color code of what color you want. For example, with the red text, you could do color equals hashtag FF0000 and that will make red text. And now for the sprite tag, which is probably the most useful text mesh pro rich text tag, because have you ever wanted to insert a custom icon into your text? Without it, you would need to insert some random image and then just hope it just lines up fine. But with the sprite tag, you can just use this tag and it will sort itself out. The process for doing so is a bit more complicated than the other tags, because in order to reference an image, you will need a Text Mesh Pro sprite atlas. But when you've gotten it all sorted out, you can set everything up with this sprite atlas. And then to get an icon in your text, all you have to do is type sprite equals 0, and that will show a sprite. The 0 will be replaced with the ID, the number ID of your sprite, but that's pretty simple. To create a sprite atlas, all you need to do is right click on an image in your project folder, and this will need to be a sprite sheet of every image that you would want to use as an icon in your text. Just keep in mind you can only use one of these, so you'll need to make sure you have everything in it. And then in your project settings, you'll just need to find Text Mesh Pro settings. And then if you look in there, there should be a field that allows you to change the default sprite asset, and then you just drag in your custom one. Everything else is pretty self-explanatory, although you might need to adjust the offset for your sprite if it doesn't line up with the text properly. Anyway, that's it for this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and next, you should check out this video where I show you something that you should absolutely not do in your code. And you might be guilty of doing this one yourself, so maybe check it out for some solutions on some better, cleaner ways to do things.